Which device are you watching this video on? If it happens to be on an Android smart device, you are using a machine running Linux at its core. Either you are using Apple devices or any browser from Safari, Firefox, and Edge to see the videos, you are not indirectly using the service powered by Linux. YouTube is hosted on thousands of servers running Linux. Not only YouTube, most big websites like Facebook, Wikipedia, Google, Amazon are all using Linux. The data from Alexa and Netcraft shows more than 70% of websites are based on Linux. Linux is not only just found in your smartphone or on the internet, but also probably present in your car. Just name a few: Hyundai from South Korea, Toyota from Japan, Mercedes-Benz from Germany, Ford, and of course Tesla from the USA. They all use Linux as the infotainment system. Besides the automotive industry, Linux is probably also present in your home. The smart TVs from Samsung and LG, and routers from TP-Link and Linksys. If you are not a techie or working in the information technology area, you may not know Linux, but it is everywhere, clearly much more present in our lives than we realize. But it tends to get overshadowed by its bigger and commercial cousins, Windows and Apple OS. Welcome to Vic's Play channel. In this video, we will go through what are Linux and its history, how does it become so popular, and what could the future of Linux be? Like Windows and Apple OS, Linux is an operating system. An operating system is system software that manages computer hardware, software resources, and provides common services for computer programs. It is like a brain that tells all the body parts to move in a certain way. Linux was not just there all of a sudden. It was inspired by its precursor, Unix. In 1969, Unix was implemented at AT&T Bell Labs due to an earlier antitrust case forbidding it from entering the computer business. AT&T has been required to license the operating system source code to anyone who asked. As a result, Unix grew quickly and became widely adopted by academic institutions and businesses. In 1984, AT&T divested itself of Bell Labs, freed of the legal obligation requiring free licensing. Bell Labs began selling Unix as a proprietary product, where users were not legally allowed to modify Unix. That causes the users to find alternatives. One consequence happened in 1991. A student from the University of Helsinki, Linus Torvalds, became curious about the operating system, but was frustrated by the licensing of Minix. So he began to work on his own operating system. He published the source code on an FTP server and invited others to add to the kernel, provided that they keep their contributions free. Thousands of programmers began working to enhance it, then the operating system grew rapidly. Eventually, the little hobby project became Linux. In the middle of 1990s, Linux starts to take the market share of Unix in supercomputing. From the late 1990s, Linux was also chosen by most websites to serve the internet. In 2007, Android was developed on Linux kernel. As a consequence, Linux became the most adopted operating system. Nowadays, Linux has become a great ecosystem and has been chosen to design different systems. So how does Linux become so popular? First, it is released at the right time. In the late 1980s, Unix changed its license model, and it is not legal and free for developers to modify it. So several groups had started to develop a Unix-like operating system. Until 1991, a famous project, GNU, completed the most components. but the low level of the kernel was incomplete and unstable. Another project, 386BSD, which was developed at the University of California, Berkeley, was not released until 1992. You may not know 386BSD, but the famous macOS and iOS descended from FreeBSD, and FreeBSD derived from 386BSD. Linus Torvalds stated, if the GNU kernel or 386BSD has been ready at that time, he probably would not have created the Linux. Like Linus, other developers were also looking for an alternative. They saw the massive potential behind the Linux project and joined the community to contribute. From then on, Linux has been steadily increasing and its community and popularity among developers mushroomed. That brings the second reason. It is free and open source based on Unix. Linux did not start from scratch. It was developed based on Minix, but was published as a free and open source. That attracted these Unix developers who were also frustrated by the Unix license and offered the developers an easy path to move from Unix to Linux. Key components from other projects like GNU has been added to the Linux. Then Linux really could be used in the production environments. Because GNU has contributed lots of codes, it was also argued to be called GNU Linux. We do not discuss the name in deep. Because Linux is free, the companies did not need to worry about additional license fees when they wanted to add servers to build more powerful supercomputers or scale their websites. Because Linux is open source, the companies are free to modify and strip out all the code they don't need when building a computer with a specific purpose in mind. Linux first took off in the supercomputing community and then the internet. The most famous example is that Android used Linux as the kernel. As a result, it makes Linux the most used operating system. In the past 30 years, about 30 million source codes have been added by thousands of developers. One developer is always there and takes care of Linux. That is Linus Torvalds. Here comes the third reason. Linus Torvalds is taking care of Linux. Since writing the first code for Linux, Linus Torvalds is always working on Linux kernel as top code gatekeepers. Although his main contribution now is to merge code written by others with a little programming, he remains the ultimate authority on what new code is incorporated into the Linux kernel. He is a legend in the world of developers and open source. Besides Linux, he also created Git, a distributed version control system. It is used to track changes in source code during software development, and almost all developers use it. That is another story. Of course, there are other reasons, such as there is a big developer community around Linux ecosystem. What is the future of Linux? Linux has a bright future. Let us look at some statistics about Linux in different areas. All top 500 supercomputers are running Linux. About 70% of the websites are using Linux. More than 70% of mobile devices are running on Linux. In the next 2 years, Linux may replace BlackBerry QNX and take the lead in automotive infotainment operating systems. It has also stepped into the space industry. SpaceX is using Linux. As technology develops very fast, we think Linux could morph into something completely different over the next couple of decades and become the OS of choice for various products and services we cannot even imagine today. We shall thank Linux. It powers much more of the global technology than most people give it credit for. A world without Linux is hard to imagine. Thanks for watching.